Now let us talk about while loop. So what I will do is I will just take a new file, so I can just write here 8_while_loop.py. okay, so while loop is similar to the for loop, but while loop is infinite, you can run it infinite number of times. So the very simple and basic syntax is while true. So while any condition is true, you can print anything. So I can just do print 1. So in this case, this is an infinite loop. If you're running this loop, have your hand on Ctrl+C to break this. So I will just show you what is happening. So it will start printing 1 continuously. You can see the cursor over here. It's going down and up here. So now I have to stop this loop. So how can I stop this? I have to just press Ctrl+C to have it break. So this will break the loop. Now I can just, if I want to, don't want to press Ctrl+C, but I want to have a break over here in the loop itself. So I can just write the keyword break over here. So I'll just save this. Now what will happen? The condition is true. It will print 1. It will break it. So let's run this and check. So I'll get print 1 only once. So this is the basic syntax. Let's go ahead. So if you want to write a while loop, you need 3 things. So first is the variable. You need to have an assignment over here. So you will assign some value. Next, you will check the value. So you need some condition over here. The second step is the condition. And the third step, which is very important, is iteration. You have to keep adding the value or do something to the value. Okay, so we'll be using all these 3 and we'll write a very small loop. So we'll just print numbers from 1 to 10 and then we'll print it from 10 to 1. Okay, so cause I want to print it from 1 to 10, so I will initialize the value as 1. Oops, so initialization. So I'll just initialize the value to 1. Then I'll say while I is less than 11. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to break this by saying if I is less than, or while I is less than 11, start printing the value. So print I. So I've done 2 steps. So I've initialized the value and I've also added a condition that run this loop until the value is less than 11. Now if I try to run this, it will again have an infinite loop. So I'll just break this now. Why? Because the value of I is 1. 1 is less than 11 and it is printing 1. So it will cause this value, or this statement is true, it will keep printing 1 or the value of I continuously. Now let's add our third line over here, which is the iteration. So let's say I equals I plus 1. So I'm assigning I plus 1 as the value. So what is happening? I'll just explain it to you. Initially the value of I is 1. Now is 1 less than 11? Yes, so it will print 1. 1 is our value, plus 1 becomes 2. So the new value of I becomes 2. So is 2 less than 11? Yes, so it will print 2. Now do you getting the point? So it is incrementing the value. Again, the value of I becomes 2 plus 1, so 3. 3 is less than 11, and it will print 3. So it will go so on. It will reach about 9. It will print 9. 9 plus 1 is 10. 10 is less than 11. It will print 10 again. 10 plus 1 is 11. 11 is not less than 11. So it will automatically break. So we don't have to add a break statement over here. It will automatically break the loop. So let's run and check this. So what is happening? So it starts from 1. It will keep adding 1 and it will start printing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. As soon as the value becomes 10, 10 plus 1 is 11. And 11 is not less than 11. So it will stop. Now we'll print the loop in the reverse way. That means I'll initialize the value to 10. Then I'll say while I is greater than 0, print I. And I equals I minus 1. So what is happening in this case? So the value of I initially is 10. So is 10 greater than 0? Yes. So it will print 10. Then 10 minus 1 is 9. So the new value becomes 9. So is 9 greater than 0? Yes. It will print 9. It will go so on until it reaches 1. So 1 minus 1 is 0 and 0 is not greater than 0. So it will print the values from 10 to 1. Let's check. So we start the values at 10 and we'll end it at 1. So now the questions what I've given or what you have been assigned for the loops, like for the for loop, you can also do this with while loop. So I'll have all the answers of all the questions using both for loop as well as while loop. I think so this is it about the loops. Stay tuned, like, share and subscribe to the channel and support us. Thank you.